Church?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Right now.
Oh.
Well, I think that means you slept through Pastor Mike's video. It's okay, we can watch it later on YouTube.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I know. It's time for worship, everybody. Stand up, because we're going to worship. Every Sunday, worship Jesus. And we're back after worship. Oof. Great.
That was great.
Great, great, great song. I just, you know, worship is great.
Mm-hmm. It was awesome.
Miss Emily, what are we learning about today? I'm so curious.
We're learning about Peter.
Ooh, okay, okay.
And Peter was a follower of Jesus. He saw Jesus do lots of miracles.
Yeah.
And he listened to Jesus, to God. Jesus gave a lot of, like, sermons and talking to people and healing people. And it was really great.
That's so cool. That's so cool.
Yeah. And, you know, Peter had, like, a lot of faith.
Oh, I know uh-huh. this story. Mm-hmm. I know, can I tell it?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Go.
Okay. So, you guys, Peter, like Miss Emily said, one of Jesus' 12 disciples. Really awesome dude. Really awesome dude. But anyway, one day, after Jesus had fed all these people, he sent the disciples out onto the lake, or to cross this river, this body of water. And Jesus said, go ahead of me, I'll catch up. So the disciples were like, okay. And so in the middle of the night, the disciples are rowing and rowing and rowing, and this storm comes out of nowhere. It's so terrifying. And they were so scared, they said, Jesus, Jesus, help us. Not knowing, Jesus was already walking towards them. Maybe he already knew that they were gonna need help. I don't know. Anyway, they were really confused because, like, is that Jesus? I don't know. So Peter said, hey, is that you, Jesus? If it is, tell me to come out of the boat and I'll walk towards you. I know.
That's a lot of faith.
I know. And so Jesus said, come to me, Peter, and walk on the water. So Peter stepped out of the boat. One of, like, probably only the only people other than Jesus to walk on water. Super awesome. Anyway, he starts walking on the water, and as he's getting closer and closer to Jesus, for some reason he takes his focus off of Jesus and looks around at the storms and the water, and it's scary, and he starts to sink. And Jesus looks at him and says, Peter cries out, Lord, help me, save me, I'm drowning. Jesus says, there's no hesitation. Jesus reached down and grabbed Peter, and he told him, why do you have so little faith? You need to know that I will always be here for you.
That's great.
You know what that means?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like in our lives, there's always things that distract us from Jesus, and we get kind of like, ooh. But if we just remember to always keep our eyes on Jesus, then it helps us keep our eyes on Jesus. So now we're going to watch this really great video about it. Okay?
Of the Bible, Peter walks on water. This is Peter.
Hey-o!
Whoop. Peter was a fisherman who was called by Jesus.
Hey!
Peter saw the many miracles of Jesus.
Wow!
And he heard all his teachings. Great crowds followed Jesus wherever he went. One day after Jesus had done a great miracle, he sent the disciples in a boat across the lake while he stayed and sent the people home.
See ya!
Hey, Jesus!
After sending them home, Jesus went up into the hills by himself to pray. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen, and they were fighting heavy waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them, walking on water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. In their fear, they cried out, "It's a ghost!"
Hold on there.
But Jesus spoke to them at once. Don't be afraid, he said. Take courage, I am here. Then Peter called to him, Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water. So Jesus said, yes, come. So Peter went over the side of the boat.
Whoa, you're awesome.
And walked on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and began to sink.
Peter, help me!
Save me, Lord, he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. Jesus said, you have so little faith. Why did you doubt me? When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped. Then the disciples worshiped him and said, you really are the Son of God.
Magic. We're back, people. Rue, wasn't that such a great video? Come on, you got more to say than that. Better. That's better. Mm-hmm. That's better. Mm-hmm. I speak lamb. Anyways.
Okay. That was great, and I think it's really important to remember to keep our eyes on Jesus. I know I don't always do it perfectly.
Me either. Sometimes it's really, really, really hard. But that's also part of why we have other people in our life that help us point us back to Jesus. And, you know, through the storms in our life, big or small, you always ask Jesus for help. And to always have faith that he will help you. Mm-hmm. And that he has a plan for you. Yes. For you and you and you and you and you. Oh yeah, me too.
Yeah, and so now we're gonna have our other worship song.
Are worship ready? Song, ready, ready, ready.
Waking up, knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I've made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted.
Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste the sea. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. And still I saw my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given's a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given's a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. Yeah.
This is living now.
Another one. Another great worship song.
Yeah, that was great.
So good.
Is there a memory verse today?
You know what? There isn't, because...
Okay, I'm ready.
Because we want everybody to just keep praying that the church is going to find a building. And, you know, remember when we said, we're going to ask Pastor Mike to help build us a playground and all that good stuff. So, just pray for that. Pray. But anyways, we love you guys.
And we miss you so much.
We miss you.
Have a great week.
Bye.
Yeah. This is one right here.